couple of months ago, Toastmaster Shri had asked a question. What is the most important life skill you'd like your children to have? I was sitting there in the audience and I immediately wrote in my notebook, emotional intelligence. Good evening, Toastmasters and dear guests.
Good evening.
So, before I talk anything about it, I'd ask all of you to look at the person who is sitting beside you and give him a bright smile. Congratulations, you all increased your emotional intelligence. So, moving on, we all might have come across a person who we thought that he would do great things in his life. A sports person for that matter, he would become a great sports person. But later on we find that he just became an average sports person. Did it happen to you?
Yes.
Chances are that he might not have practiced emotional intelligence, because of which he remained average. So, talking about emotional intelligence was made famous by the famous psychologist Dan Goleman in 1996 in his book Emotional Intelligence. He defined emotional intelligence using four tenets. The first tenet is self-awareness, second is self-regulation, third is social awareness or empathy, and fourth is human relationship management. So now let's take a sample emotion, anger. If I am angry and I have a good amount of EQ, I know that I am angry. Self-awareness. Self-regulation. I am angry and I know how to control that anger. Self-regulation. Social awareness or empathy. Somebody yells at me, oh, and I'm like, I know how to control my anger and I know how to conduct myself. Empathy. He might have had a bad day at school or work. Empathy. And human relationship management, knowing how, why anger comes out of anyone and to eradicate it. So, I'd like to share a simple observation which I made during the last few months in my society. I play tennis most of the times. And one day when I was playing tennis, I saw two kids who were playing tennis during non-school hours. So, I asked my partner, bro, why are these kids playing tennis during school hours? He told that they don't go to school. I was like, really? It was something new to me. Then when I asked I got more intrigued and I asked him more. He told that these kids are homeschooled. A tutor comes to them and he teaches them. They'll be able to give their 10th and 12th board. But and the father of those kids is an educationist. He does not believe in the Indian education system. He believes that it gives a lot of stress to students, and that's why he did not allow them to go to school, and he takes them to different kind of plays, some adventure clubs, he takes them to slums, and so he wants his children to have different perspectives of life. So I was very impressed with that. I thought I would also do the same. But later on, after a few weeks, I saw one of the kids who was playing there tennis. He was playing football. So I observed that he was having a problem coordinating with others, students. So then I tried to relate it to emotional intelligence, and I saw that the kid, he was able to fulfill the first two tenets, self-awareness and self-regulation, but because he did not have exposure to other students and other people, he might not be as successful, because later on in later stages he might have to deal with other people. So that intrigued me and told me that emotional intelligence is so important in life. Next, I like to share how can we improve our emotional intelligence. So for that, I would like to give a big thank you to Toastmaster Aradhana. Last week she had a great theme of spreading smile. And that is what I made you all do during the few minutes back. So that is the most simplest way of increasing your emotional quotient. Last week I tried this experiment. For 2 days I smiled at strangers and I was so happy that around 80% of the strangers smiled back at me and made me so happy and satisfied. So I also increased my emotional intelligence. then what happened, another story which I'd like to share is that a man is walking on a road, okay, he fell down in a drain hole. He fell down in that drain hole and there was no other way to get out of that drain hole other than asking for help. So a doctor was passing through that street and he says, doctor, get me out of here. So doctor writes prescription, drops it and goes. Next is priest was passing by. Father, get me out of this hole. The priest prayed for 2 minutes and said, son, God will take you out of this hole. Then he saw his friend going from there. Now let's imagine that friend is Ranjan. Ranjan, get me out of this hole. So Ranjan jumped into that hole, held his hand. Bro, I know your situation and I'm surely gonna take you out of this hole. And he takes him out of this hole. So in the end, what I'm trying to make a point here is that we all have human connections with everybody. And those connections will surely come back and help you in times of need. We can have prescriptions, technology, religion, all form an important part of our society. But without human relationships, we are nothing. And simple initiatives like sharing a smile will increase our emotional quotient and also help us become successful and lead great lives in future. Thank you.